Welcome back to Studio D. Well, we've got this week's box office, and in it, we've got some odd kids showing off their abilities. Some folks turned one of the biggest bank robberies in U.S. history into a comedy, and Marky Mark is taking on one of the biggest disasters in U.S. history. First up, we're heading to a strange class with Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children.
Jake, right on time. Miss Peregrine, delighted to meet you.
He's invisible.
Of course. We're what's known in common parlance as peculiar.
Claire, why aren't you eating?
She's embarrassed in front of Jake.
Don't be.
When Jacob discovers clues to a mystery that spans different worlds and times, he finds Miss Peregrine's home for peculiar children. All right, I'm not sure how I feel about this one. It's a Tim Burton film, so you know it's going to be at least a good story, and it's adapted from a book, if that means anything to you. Though these kids creep me out. The
yes.
ones that are covered up look yeah. like Michael Jackson's kids from back in the day, and I don't know what she's doing with that glove. I mean, this just looks really weird.
Blanket.
Just weird. All right, I get it. Some kids have some special abilities, and this lady wants to keep them safe and teach them how to embrace their powers. I feel like, haven't I seen this somewhere before? I think, haven't
I? In public, we're merely a school for gifted youngsters. Cyclops, Storm, and Jean were some of my first students. I protected them, taught them to control their powers, and in time, teach
I knew it! X-Men. Look,
yeah.
Look, unless that girl with the mouth thing on the back of her head has some claws that come out of her hands, I'm probably going to pass on
What
this
did she
one.
Do with her front mouth?
I don't know.
That is so
I
weird. Why didn't she just eat this one? She had a mouth still. It's
but,
weird.
But Samuel Jackson's in this because he's in everything. So
yeah,
he plays the
true.
Bad guy in the movie. So at least there's that.
Oh, that's one reason to watch, I guess.
There you go. All right, next up, Zach Galifianakis is stealing a ton of money in Masterminds.
What would you do with $1 million?
Probably start my own business. Maybe be a bounty hunter.
Nice.
You know, put a cap in their house.
Oh! Oh, that burns!
Oh, my gosh, David, let me see!
Oh, God!
I think that bullet just went straight between your cheeks.
Yeah, it feels like it just grazed my biscuits right there betwixt them.
Kelly tells me y'all work together over at Loomis. That strikes me as an incredible opportunity.
You talk about robbing a bank.
How hard can it be? You load up a truck,
I'm not dead!
And you drive away.
A night guard at an armored car company in the southern U.S. organizes one of the biggest bank heists in American history. This basically looks like one of big SNL skit
yes,
because
yeah.
almost everyone in it was on the show at some point.
Right.
I think this looks like a little bit of a dopey comedy, though. They did delay it 6 times. 18 months it's
wow.
been delayed
for
the, before they released
That's
it.
That's a bad sign.
That's
huh?
a very bad
Uh-oh.
Sign.
I mean, well, that little Lord Fauntleroy haircut he's got going on.
Well, this, well,
That's
so
a bad sign.
This should have a few funny parts. I just hope they didn't put them all in the trailer. And this is based on a true story.
Okay.
I actually watched a little bit of the documentary with the real characters, and they're as dopey as they seem in the movie as they do in real life. So they're not that far off. But, you know, Zach Galifianakis is playing almost, the guy almost got away with the theft. It was $17.3 million.
Ooh.
Now, it's an interesting story how these guys got caught. They ran off to Mexico. America went and dragged them back. However, I'd rather see the true story behind this robbery attempt. Look at this guy. Okay.
What?
All right. He's scoping it out. I don't know
That's
what's going on.
That's not his real stomach,
I don't know what's going on there. He's trying to hide it. And
that
then,
is...
oh, look, I didn't see your face a minute ago.
No.
Here we go.
I'm out.
Oh, he falls down.
What's in his pants?
I don't know. That's what he was trying to steal. He looked like a hefty guy. There was some food there. Maybe that's what he's going after.
That cannot be all stomach. Like, how low can you go? I mean, that's just, it was very, I had a donut. Sorry, go ahead.
But see, I want to see the true story behind that. And we have a third film this week, which is a little interesting for this time of year. Mark Wahlberg is trying to save everyone he can in the middle of the Gulf of Mexico with Deepwater Horizon.
Is there someone at your door?
Are you seeing this? Get everybody off the-
Mike, what is that? Is everything okay?
We gotta go right now!
I'll call you back, I'll call you back!
caving in.
A story set on the offshore drilling rig Deepwater Horizon, which exploded during April 2010 and created the worst oil spill in U.S. history. Now, I remember when this incident happened, and it was horrible.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, millions of fish died. Mm-hmm. It completely, you know, handicapped all of the fishing in Florida and Louisiana and through Mexico. I mean, it was a really bad disaster. Also, more facts have come out about just how cheaply built and maintained that rig was that caused this horrible tragedy. Mm. And I'm glad Mark Wahlberg is putting this out there so everyone can see what happened from the perspective of the crew that was on that rig. Though Mark is a businessman and he's always looking for an opportunity to cross promote, that's why I'm pretty sure he came up with this.
The BP Wahlburgers.
The oil film special edition.
Horrible.
All right, thank you very much. Well, we'll be right back on Studio D. We're looking at a game of charades taken to the extreme over Hollywood Boulevard. Stay tuned to see Hollywood's funniest try their hand at this classic game.
I'm really.